All of you, myself Abhijit sir, my today's video is first under date physics chapter 1, that is kinetic theory of matter. Now first of all we should know about what is Brownian motion. A famous botanist, that is Robert Brown, now he took some pollen grain and put them in water. Now he saw that when the pollen grains are in water, after when they absorb sufficient amount of water, they burst into fine particles and they began to move here and there in the zigzag motion. Now when he saw that in a microscope, now this motion was very much irregular and they move in zigzag motion. So this motion was known as Brownian motion. Next, we'll go to particles of matter. Now first of all, what is matter? Now matter is anything that has weight and has space. Now most of the things that you see around us are made up of matter. It may be air, water, any solid particles, maybe this pen, anything that is called matter. Now first of all, what is element? Now element is a substance which cannot be subdivided into two or more simpler substance by any chemical means. Now element in turn is composed of molecules or atom. Now if the matter is made up of only one kind of element, then the smallest unit of the element is called atom. That is, atom definition is, you should know the definition first of all of atom. An atom is defined as the smallest unit of element. Now if the matter is made up of two or more different elements, then the smallest unit is called molecule. The molecule definition is like this. A molecule is defined as the smallest unit of matter which has an independent existence and can retain complete physical and chemical property of the matter. For example, molecule of water. So molecule of water formula is what? H2O. That is, it contains both hydrogen and oxygen. Next, you should know about kinetic theory of matter. Now kinetic theory of matter was the result of labor of number of eminent scientists of the 17th, 18th and 19th century. Now what are the main theories of this kinetic theories of matter? Now, first of all, the matter consists of molecule. The matter is made up of molecule. It can be for example water. Water formula is H2O. It contains two hydrogen and one oxygen. The second point is molecules are always in random motion. The molecules are always in random motion. They move in the zigzag motion, which you have seen before also. Third point is the molecule attract one another with a force which decreases when the distance between them increases. This means that the force of attraction is inversely proportional to the distance. More the distance, less is the attraction force. Less is the distance, more is the attraction force. So there are two kinds of forces are there. First of all, force of cohesion, and second is force of addition. The force of cohesion is the force between the molecules of same substance. The force between two atoms of mercury, example is the force between the two atoms of mercury. And the force of addition is the intermolecular force between the molecule of different substance. For example, the force between the molecules of gum and the paper. That means when you stick any paper to another paper, you use gum, and the force between the gum and the paper, that is called force of addition. The fourth point is molecule of a given substance are all alike and differ from the molecules of other substance. The fifth point is the kinetic energy of the molecule depend on the temperature. It increases with the rise in temperature. That means kinetic energy is directly proportional to the temperature. More the temperature, more is the kinetic energy. Less the temperature, less is the kinetic energy. Know about physical difference between solid, liquid and gases on the basis of kinetic theory. Now matter can exist in three different states, that is solid, liquid and gases. The three states can be easily distinguished on the basis of the unique characteristic. For example, a solid has a definite shape and size. And the intermolecular force of attraction is very high in solid, and the intermolecular space is very less or negligible in case of solid. That is why solid has definite shape, size and volume. Next, about liquid. Now liquid has definite size or volume but no definite shape of its own. It takes up the shape of the container in which it is placed. Suppose you are taking water in a glass, so the water will take the shape of the glass. If you pour some water in a bottle, it will take the shape of the bottle. Now, according to kinetic theory, the molecules of a liquid are farther apart from each other and then the molecules of a solid. That means in the case of liquid, the intermolecular force of attraction is less than solid but more than gases, and the intermolecular space is more than solid but less than gases. The molecules are quite free to adjust themselves to the shape of the vessel. A liquid has definite size but no definite shape. Third, gases. A gas has neither definite shape or not definite volume. It takes up the shape of the entire container and occupies the whole space available. If you open a bottle of perfume, the aroma fills the whole room. If you open the door, the aroma fills to the next room. You can take more example like LPG cylinder. The gas is poured in the LPG cylinder. If you just open the gas or the gas is open, you can smell the gas coming out. That means it take up the shape of the entire container. According to kinetic theory of gases, the intermolecular space is very large as compared to solid and liquid, and the intermolecular force of attraction is minimum than solid or liquid, or you can say intermolecular attraction is zero. A gas has no definite shape or size of its own. Energy contained in the three states of matter. In solid, the particles have less energy, that is, they are tightly packed. In liquid, the particles have more energy than solid but less than gases. In gas, the particles have the most energy, that is, they are free to move in any direction. A change of state. Now, a phase is distinctive form of a substance, and matter can change among the phase. Now, first of all, you should know about the various changing of state. First of all, boiling. Now, what is boiling? A boiling is a process in which a substance changes its state from liquid state to gaseous state. Now, when a liquid is heated, the particles give more energy. They start to move faster and farther apart. At the certain temperature, the particles break free from one another and the liquid turn into gas. This is called boiling point. The boiling point of a substance is always the same. It does not vary. For example, the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. Now, boiling is fast process in which bubbles are formed and occur at definite temperature called boiling point. Next is vaporization. Now, it is the process of changing of substance from liquid to gaseous state without boiling. That is called vaporization. For example, if you see the water in the pond, they vaporizes in the summer time and the water level in the pond goes down. That is due to vaporization. But its temperature is less than the boiling point. It occurs at temperature less than boiling point. Next is melting. Now, melting is a process in which a substance changes from solid to liquid. For example, ice melts. The temperature at which this change from solid to liquid happens in the melting point. And the melting point of ice is 0 degree Celsius. That means at 0 degree, the solid ice will change to liquid. Evaporation. Evaporation is a specific type of vaporization which occurs at temperature below the boiling point of a liquid. It is same as you are drying clothes, you put it out in the sun and you see the wet clothes becoming dry after some time. This is due to evaporation of water. It occurs at a temperature less than the boiling point. Now, evaporation is responsible for drying clothes and transpiration in plant. Water never comes to boil in this case, but rather evaporates away. Now, evaporation is a slow process in which no bubbles are formed and can occur in all temperature. Next is condensation. Now, it is the process in which a substance changes from gas to a liquid. Now, dewdrop example is dewdrop. From gas, it changes to liquid. Next is sublimation. The sublimation is the process in which a substance changes directly from a solid to a gas without going through the liquid phase. For example, camphor, a naphthalene ball, it changes directly from solid to gaseous state without going through the liquid state. Next is deposition. That is the process in which a substance changes directly from a gas to a solid without going through the liquid state. For example, the ice crystals are frost. Next is freezing. Now, freezing, that is the process in which a substance changes from a liquid to a solid. Now, in this chart, it will help you out to know about the various processes. Solid, liquid, gas. A solid, if it directly changes to gas, it is called sublimation. And gas, if it directly changes to solid without going through the liquid state, it is called deposition. The solid, if it changes to liquid, it is called melting. And liquid, if it changes to solid state, it is called freezing. Liquid, if it changes to gaseous state, it is called vaporization. And gases, if it changes to liquid state, it is called condensation. This chart is very important. The comparison of three states of matter. The properties, solid, liquid and gases. Shape. Solid have definite shape. Liquid do not have definite shape. Gases do not have definite shape. Volume. The solid have definite volume. Here also liquid also have definite volume. But gases do not have definite volume. Next is density. Solid have very high density. Its density is less as compared to solid but more as compared to gases. Gases have least density. 4 is kinetic energy of particle. Solid has least kinetic energy. Liquid has more than solid. And gases have maximum kinetic energy. The compressibility. Solid cannot be compressed. That is zero, negligible. Liquid, the compressibility is low. And gases, the compressibility is high. Now you should see, we should know this important point. Let's see it again. You should learn all this, okay? All these points are very much important, and you can try out these short questions in your home. Fill in the blanks, definition, you should learn all these things. Okay, thank you.